Hey guys, it's Peter,
and I'm back.
Of course I'm back. I'm not going anywhere. Boost!
Little fan.
I'm YouTube famous now!
The album, Dad AF. Like salt and pepper, but not salt and pepper.
Dad AF!
Salt and pepper, salt and pepper.
Let's talk about sex, baby. Let's talk about you and me. Let's talk about all the good things and the bad.
My friends and I used to dance that song so much in the clubs. Y'all love that song back in the day? Well, the reason I'm singing that song is because we're going to talk about Jeffree Star and Tana Mojo's collab today. But I think before we do, I just got my hair cut. I'm not really sure what I think. So I think I'm going to put a little clip in here just like Jeffree. And then I'll just sit here. I kind of love that look of Jeff. I put my fan down over there. I just kind of placed it down. I love that look that Jeffree has with that pink thing in the side of his hair. I really do like that. But anyway, so here's the deal. Okay, here's the situation. Here's the deal. I have gotten so many requests for this video of my response to Tana Mojo and Jeffree Star and James Charles doing these two collabs, right? And it's funny. I mean, I literally every day I'm getting tweeted. Are you doing the video? Are you doing the video? Are you doing the video? I have gotten more requests for this video, my reaction to that collab, than I have to people wanting me to do a mukbang at Bob Evans for sausage, biscuits, and gravy. I already did it. It's over there, okay? By the way, in the last couple days, I have gotten so many people that have requested. Look at this. Here's something about Mary. I have gotten so many requests from people asking me to go do those lip freak chapsticks or whatever. I did a whole video about it like 6 months ago. I tried all the lip freaks, so go check it out. Anyway, so I watched both videos and I'm gonna give you my reaction. Why not? I have to tell you first though, my favorite shade moment, if you watched just the Jeffree Star and the Tana Mojo, my favorite shade moment, okay, was when Jeffree said, okay, let's go in with concealer, and she goes, and Tana goes, but not Kat Von D concealer, right? I lived. Because if you know the history, Jeffree Star and Kat Von D are no longer friends. Ding-a-ling-a-ling, shim-a-lang, ding-ding-dong, ding. Oh, ow, 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 that was the drama phone. This is Peter speaking. Tana Mojo drama, 1995 today, only, yeah. It's real hot today. Oh, hi, Jade, how are you? The ladies auxiliary on Sunday, I don't know, I might still be hot and bothered, not hot, Jade, but hot and bothered from watching this Jeffree Star Tana Mojo video. I might not make it to the ladies auxiliary this week, I might take a day off. Well, all right, Jane, bye. So anyway. Let's get right into what I thought about these videos. So both of them, first of all, were like 20 minutes long, which I was like, I'm the king of making 20 minute videos, not y'all. So here's the thing. Okay, it's interesting when you are an uber fan of YouTube like me and you start seeing these collabs happen all over the place, right? And it's like somebody that's like, you know, a comedian, supposedly, like Tana Mojo is a comedian, a storyteller. I don't know what she is, but anyway, I don't know what category she fits into, rapper, comedian, I don't know who she is. But anyway, Tana Mojo over here, and then Jeffree Star, who's a beauty guru, right? Or Christine Seidelko and Manny Mua. It's interesting when you pull them both together and you see what happens. The Christine Seidelko and Manny Mua collab, I absolutely loved. I thought it was hilarious, right? Now, I will tell you, 100% candor right here, I kind of really loved these two collabs that I watched with Jeffree Star and Tana Mojo. I don't know that loved is, maybe love's a little harsh of a word to say. What's love got to do? Not a whole lot. But anyway, there were laughable moments. I thought they were well done. I honestly thought that I would sit there like this and be like, I just can't with this. But I laughed. I thought it was funny. There were a lot of funny moments in both of them, right? But let me tell you what was very, very obvious watching it. Except for the age difference between Tana and Jeffree, which was very obvious to me. What was really interesting was that, like, you know, Tana on her channel, if you watch her own, if you watch her channel alone, which I have because, you know, I've followed her career, I've made many videos about Tana Mojo. So I've seen it, and it's, you know, like, she does these outrageous story times and all this kind of stuff, and it is what it is, but, like, on her channel, it kind of fits her because it's not, like, you know, played against something else. But, like, Jeffree Star has a lot of true natural wit, you know, and sarcasm. So, like, his just kind of comes out in what he's doing. So he's like, you know, yeah, Scott, you know, it's all like that. And then he kind of, like, weaves in a story. He's, like, kind of a natural storyteller. Well, when you place that against Tana, what's really obvious to me is how hard she really tries, you know? And, I mean, she tries really hard in both of these videos to be funny and, you know, tell these outrageous stories and, You know, it's just at some point, it's like the drug blowjob references, they're just not funny after a while. You know what I mean? I don't care. Even if you do drugs, even if you're giving a blowjob a minute, like Misty on the floor at the bathroom in high school, I don't really care, okay? But it gets old after a while. It's just, it's like, is that your only like comedic line to go to? Like, you're supposedly a comedian. You're supposedly a storyteller, right? You have millions of subscribers. And I'm also sitting there wondering, I'm like, if this is her point of reference for everything, are these the stories she tells in her show that people are paying $200 for and the majority of the people that are coming are between the ages of 12 and 17? Like, this is what you're telling, right? To people, like, what you do at festivals and how, you know, much you use and the sex you have. And it's whatever. I mean, she's a 19-year-old young lady. She can do whatever she wants to do, right? But I'm sitting there and I'm watching this and I'm thinking to myself, you know, 10 years down the road, like, what's your long-term plan if this YouTube thing doesn't run out, right? I will also say that for James Charles, one of the things that was interesting to me is that, you know, I think that James has really taken his career a lot more seriously. I mean, Jeffrey, at this point, you know, he can kind of say whatever he wants to say. He owns his own makeup company. You know, I'm not saying he can say whatever he wants to say, but, you know, in telling stories, sexual stories, things like that. I mean, and I will say, like, he's still, you know, this is the art of storytelling. He still, like, holds back a little bit. It's not, like, grotesque. And I mean, it was, but not as much. I don't know. It just wasn't as much as her. But, like, James tells this story when they do the mukbang together, and I'm sitting there, and first of all, I'm like, okay, now, having watched James Charles' videos, this is way too much information, and we didn't need to know all that, James, okay? I'm glad that you're so comfortable around your good duties, but number two, you want to get, like, major sponsorships with major makeup companies, and I'm telling you down the road, what you just told, somebody is going to copy and put it on a reel on YouTube to play forever, okay? And you got to kind of think about that stuff when you put that out there in the world. I'm just saying, you know, like, if you're on his level, I mean, if you're on the rest of ours level, who'd care, you know? But anyway, so I'm sitting there and I'm watching all of it, and the first part was, it was okay. It was cute. The Jeffree Star, you know, and it has like 2.5 million views, right? So they're doing like a very, like a get ready with me, and they're going through products and all this kind of stuff. And she does herself on her own face and he does himself. I would have much preferred if he had done her face or vice versa. It would have been funnier. It would have either been educational or it would have been funny, if that makes sense. This was kind of just like, I don't know, like two people sitting around. It's like, okay, here's what it was, right? You know, you had that girlfriend back in the day, and she constantly complaining that she don't have a boyfriend, right? You know what I'm talking about? She sits at home with her five cats, and, you know, all she does is just complain about her life, right? So it's a Friday night, and you're like, what do you want to do? And she's like, I need a boyfriend. And we're like, okay, listen, Sue. Okay, we're going to take you out, and we're going to get you all dressed up. We're going to do a makeover. She's like, I get a makeover? You're like, yes, we're going to do a makeover on you. And then we're going to take you out. We're going to get you some of those sex on the beaches that you like so much. Don't drink more than two, because, you know, you start dancing on the floor and thinking you can twerk and all that kind of stuff. You can't. So anyway, and then at the end, you sit there and look at her, and you and your friends are like, oh no, what did we do? Like, the makeover has gone too far, okay? Like, too far. Too much makeup, too much, right? And you're like, she ain't gonna get no boyfriend. People are gonna run. So anyway, that's kind of what Tana looked to me a little bit like at the end. Like, she looked like she was, do y'all remember Brooke Shields and Pretty Baby? That, okay? Like, too much. It was just like over the top. And I was like, and she's a pretty girl. Tana Mojo is a pretty girl. I mean, she is. I've seen some really nice pictures of her when, you know, she doesn't have a whole lot of makeup on it. And she's probably that girl that doesn't need a lot of makeup. Now, shower and wash and dry her hair, I'd go with that all day long. She looked like she had a, you know, she looked like she'd been traveling down 10 miles of Battle Texas Highway. She looked like she had been traveling for a while, okay? Now, here's the other thing. Tana Mojo put this, you know, collab off for a day, okay? And then she shows up at 1 o'clock in the morning. We all saw the tweets. I did the video about it and all this kind of stuff, right? Well, and then James Charles had tweeted out, like, the week before, I have a meeting with Tana Mojo, 8 o'clock in the morning or 9 o'clock in the morning. I know I'll show up alone or something to that effect, right? Here is what kills me, right? You know, is she the Meryl Streep of YouTube? Like, I mean, she's not, right? Why is everybody so dying to do a collab with this girl that they let her get away with everything? Seriously? I'm telling you right now, if I had a collab to do with Tana Mojo, I mean, she'd be as late as she wanted to be, thank God. But anyway, I'd just be like, oh my God, I can't believe I'm doing a collab with Tana Mojo. But I did, if she showed up late to me and I was as big as they are, I'd be like, I'm sorry, girl, no, okay? Gal, you need to pack your bags and your Red Bull and you need to go hit it, okay? Because we ain't doing no collab. I'm going to bed. I'm getting in there with my husband. We're watching Netflix. She showed up too late. You want to do it a week from now? You show up on my time, okay? But anyway, they did the collab anyway. It is what it is. But I did think about the perfect collab for Tana Mojo and I to do. Like, as if she's asking, right? Because it's always interesting to me when you see, like, different kinds of YouTubers and, like, when they come together and they do a collab. But I think, can you imagine... Now, hold on a second, okay? Can you imagine if Tana Mojo and I did a collab and we reenacted an episode of Dr. Phil...
Absolutely, Oprah.
Now, Tana, let me ask you a question. In almost every video that you show, Tana, you talk about all these drugs you use and how you're constantly having sex in the puss house. Now, Tana, do you think that is good role modeling, Tana? Well, Dr. Phil, I mean, it makes for... Now, Tana, I've seen your story times, Tana, and I just don't think that it makes show in a very good light. Now, do you, Tana?
Absolutely, Oprah.
I would love to do a Dr. Phil recreate with Tana Mojo. I think that would be fantastic. But she's already done the fake-ass Maury show with... Anyway. So, then I go over, and I did laugh. There were cute moments in the video. But anyway, then I go over and I watch The Mukbang, okay? With James Charles, Tana Mojo, and Jeffree Star. Which I almost titled this video... James Charles and Tana Mojo disappointing Jeffree Star for 2 minutes straight because Tana Mojo calls it out in the video, and I thought that was kind of funny, actually. An homage to the drama channels by Tana Mojo. But anyway, so I watched the video. It was funny. Like, okay, the part where they drive through the Jack in the Box, first of all, Jack in the Box is junk. I can't stand it, okay? This is, like, the thing that kills me about Jack in the Box on a little side note. It is one of the only restaurants that is open late besides White Castle, and our Taco Bell is open till 2. I don't know why theirs wasn't. But it is shit food. It is nasty, okay? But what I love about this mukbang is that Tana's the one that wants to do it, right? But you can tell watching it, Jeffree Star's the only one that knows how to do anything. He, like, takes the box and holds it up to the camera. I'm like, oh, she's a natural mukbanger all day long showing the food. But let me tell you a little secret that I got sent, okay? Now, I don't know if this was, like, some fake account that's using Jeffree Star's picture or I don't know, right? But before he did this video, I think it was, like, the day before he did this video, he put up, like, an Instagram story or somebody. Somebody sent this to me, okay? And it was, like, his face, and then down the middle it said Trisha and Tana. And he said, who would you rather have me do a video with, right? And underneath it, he wrote, unless, and it could be, allegedly, it could be a fake account, he said, I vote Trisha. I vote Trisha, too, all day long. I cannot believe Jeffree Star, you know, broke his mukbang virginity with Tana Mojo when Trisha Paytas is over there. And apparently they are gonna do a video together. When Trisha Paytas is over here waiting to do a video with you, and she is literally the mukbang queen. I mean, besides you with Chunky. But I love Trisha Paytas' eating videos so much. You should have saved that video for them, right? So anyway, this whole video, it is what it is, and it kills me, but like... Jeffree Star is like, okay, have you ever had, like, the weekend when your dad's out of town and you, like, are, like, Tana's age, like, 1920, and you come home and you've been drinking and your stepmom's been sitting around, like, I've lived this story, okay, and she's been having a little bit of wine, too, and then you bring your good Judy with you, and y'all are sitting around talking and all that kind of stuff, and then it just kind of, like, goes into this conversation that maybe it shouldn't go into. Well, that's what this reminded me very much, okay? Jeffree Star's a stepmom in this situation. And I loved the reference when they start talking about Anthony Hopkins, and Tana asks him, you know, what's your darkest tattoo? And he says, well, my Silence of the Lambs, something about Anthony Hopkins. And I almost said Anthony Perkins. But anyway, that would have been real long ago. She and James have no clue who he is, okay? I'm like, you are dating yourself, Jeffrey. But anyway, who doesn't love a good Silence of the Lambs, seriously? But then she goes in and she starts talking about all this gross stuff. I mean, it is like sex, 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 sex. It's just too much, okay? It's way too much. James was funny in it. I will say this, okay? What killed me was, through the whole, I mean, and we're now on our second video, okay? Through the whole video, Jeffree Star still has this clip in his hair. And halfway through eating, okay? And you can tell somebody's true class by how they eat. halfway through eating, he starts pulling out his palette and redoing his makeup, which I lived for all day long. But I will say, the only one out of all three of them whose makeup looked actually glam in the video was James Charles, which I thought was kind of funny. But it was all right. I mean, I don't know why everybody wanted me to respond to this. I mean, what did I think of it over the top? You know, I would not need to see a whole lot more Jeffree Star collabs with Tana Mojo. I would like to see a Jeffree Star James Charles collab, but I wasn't super interested in it. I didn't think, and I would love to see a Jeffree Star Christine Seidelko collab, but this one, I would love to see a Jeffree Star Peter Mon collab. Hint, hint. So it wasn't like, you know, the greatest video I'd ever seen in the entire world, but it wasn't the worst collab. I've seen some bad collabs out there. Y'all know what I mean? But it wasn't like that at all. But people ask me now, since I talked about my psychic abilities the other day, they're like, what is your prediction, okay, of Jeffree Star and Manny and all these people? Well, I'm going to tell you, since I talked about Jeffree Star today, I don't know what Tana Mojo is. I can't see her in the future, so I don't know what my predictions are for her. I'll have to, like, get out my crystal ball and do a little fortune telling. But for Jeffree Star, I'm going to tell you, I don't know why I have this feeling. I see Jeffree Star in a movie, very much like James Bond, playing the villain. Almost kind of like an ode to Grace Jones in View to a Kill. That's what I see coming forward for Jeffree Star. Can you imagine Jeffree Star as a villain in a movie? I would love it all day long. Anyway, I love you guys. Let me know what you think in the comment section below about the Jeffree, Tana, James video. And if you liked it, if you didn't like it, if you thought it was problematic, listen. It wasn't as problematic as we thought it was going to be. So thank God for that. Anyway, I love you guys, and I will see you tomorrow. Bye.